What's up, everybody? Welcome back to WPG Clark Podcast. Today we're here with
Sandman.
How you doing today, bro?
I'm doing good, bro. I'm doing good.
That's good. Before we get this interview going, I want to remind y'all, like, comment, and subscribe. We got the new studio going right now. So we're gonna have more videos coming out of here. And rolling into this, man, Sandman. So where are you from, man? What was your come up like?
I'm from Winnipeg, Manitoba. Born and raised here, as well as Italy. Small town there, you know. That's where I'm from.
What was it like over there growing up, man?
It was pretty chill. It was a different experience, definitely. I got to experience a different side of the world, you know. It wasn't all like glamorous or anything, but it is what it was. I was happy that I was there, you know. Definitely shaped me in terms of like style and personality and music and all that kind of stuff.
So what types of music were you listening to like early on in your life?
So I first started listening to mostly like pop music and whatnot. The first artist plural, I guess, that I started listening to was like the Beatles. That was like the first time I was like, ooh, I actually am interested in like music, I guess, in a sense, was them.
Do you remember like what Beatles track it was and where you heard it?
Yeah, it was called Hey Jude, and it was through just like a random advertisement, like a movie commercial.
Okay.
Trailer, yeah.
Classic.
Yeah.
Classic song. So when did you like first start making music and think that like music was a thing for you and wanted to get into it?
Probably around grade 11 is when I started making beats in my spare time.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what was it that got you into like making beats?
Well, I was definitely heavily into Kanye. You know, still one of my favorite artists, definitely biggest influences.
Okay.
And yeah, like, I just, like, his whole story of making beats and then becoming an artist, I was, like, mad inspired. And I was, like, in his style of how he just does whatever the fuck he wants with his music, I was, like,
yeah.
I want to make beats, too.
He's definitely really creative, like, when it comes to
sampling
and, like, all the different sounds.
Like, people, like, I mean, obviously now, like, he's got, you know, his controversies and whatever, but I think that's like all a part of like what makes him crazy is that he's just like, he doesn't give a shit about anything. Like, he just makes what he wants, he says what he wants, he does, you know, obviously sometimes it's not the best stuff, but
man, he really puts himself like out there publicly, like,
yeah,
with just his thoughts and like
he,
you know,
he's just him like to the fullest extent, which is like what I fuck with heavily, you know. You see it in his music all the time. It's just like it's just authentic.
Yeah.
So
So what was like your first track that you made where you transitioned from making beats to, you know, rapping or singing or doing your thing on it?
So my first ever time recording my own song was when it was grade 11 or 12, I can't remember, but it was like just sitting in my room middle of the night, like 3 a.m. I was just like, you know what? Let me just look for beats. So I decided I'd look for beats. And I found like this lo-fi track. And then I was like, hey, I just recorded on my little blue snowball mic, you know? And I was just like, took what the knowledge I had gained, I guess, from producing beats and like mixing and stuff and just applied it to the vocals and recorded it that night, posted on SoundCloud the next day. And then that was the first time, yeah.
Is it still up on your SoundCloud?
Oh, yeah. Aside from a couple tracks that I did take down, just because I was like, I do not fuck with these at all. I left most of my music, you can still find it on SoundCloud, like, from when I first started. Just because it's, like, I kind of look at it as, like, a journal now. It's, like, I don't really post my music on there anymore. But, like, I will, with every release, I'll put it on there, too, just because it's, like, you know, have it on everything. But, yeah, I just kind of have it as, like, a little reminder, like, oh, this is how I started, and this is, like, how far, I guess, I've came in a sense, and people can see that if they want, they can go look. And
it's like when people fucking mark their height in a doorway.
Yeah,
their house,
exactly.
You know?
That's SoundCloud to me now. It's just like a little archive of a little, you know, time capsule, I guess.
So, I want to ask you about your first music video? Gemini?
Okay, yeah, Gemini. Gemini was, well, I had filmed actually a different music video before that for one of those older SoundCloud songs. I did.
Okay.
And it just ended up not really, it was kind of like, we filmed it, it took a long time, and by then I was already working on like new sounds and stuff. So
okay.
I kind of just gave up on it, and we were like, eh, let's scrap it.
So you didn't put it out?
No.
Yeah.
But yeah, so like, I guess Gemini in a sense really is like my first, like, well, like, to the T, like, planned out, executed, like, yeah, music video.
Yeah. What was the whole process like? Did you make the song and you're like, I need to do a video for this too? Like,
no,
how did you pick that song?
Well, the song itself came out, I think it was 2019.
Okay.
2019, yeah. And then I ended up releasing, and then, yeah, I dropped it, and it was, like, the first time it gained, like, first of my songs to really get, like, a lot of traction, and it had, like, no promotion. Like, I just put it out, and people, like, gravitated towards it, and I was just, like, you know, and it was a very, like, personal song, too. It was, like, still one of, like, my favorite song I think I've made to this day. The video came a year later, and I mean, like, I always wanted to do a video for it.
Okay.
But it was kind of, like, it had to be right, you know, like, it had to be done right.
Yeah.
And it had to be, like, the right time, I guess, too.
So how'd you go about, like, getting the videographer and everything?
Well, I basically was, like, that was the thing. I actually had hit up a couple different videographers, but wasn't, you know, it was kind of just, like, in the DMs, like, hey, like, you know, like, it was, like, I kind of just was searching and whatnot, and there was, like, a mutual guy that I knew through my homie Sean 2K.
Okay.
Who, shout out Sean 2K. But he told me about this guy, he's friends with this videographer, and whatnot. Hadn't made a music video, though, but I was,
okay,
like, you know, like, I checked him out, and I thought he was dope, so I hit him up. His name's Aiden, shout out AFN, Aiden, that's the homie, he's my brother.
Hey, shout out to him.
Yeah, man, that was, like, the start of, like, yeah, definitely a high, like a level up in my career, I guess. Like, meeting him was definitely a very big, important thing.
Because you felt like, now I can do so much more for my music.
Yeah. And, like, I pitched it to him. I was just like, hey, like, I have this song, whatever. Like, we met up and did it in person to talk about it.
Yeah.
And we just talked about ideas and just, like, bounced off each other. And the energy was there. And he was just, like, into it. I was like, hey, I just want to film a video. But it's not, like, I just want it to be, like, literally just, like, a little
sunflowers and fields and
yeah, well, I mean, all that stuff ended up was, like, it was, like, a spur of the moment, but that's what,
yeah,
I wanted the video to be. I wanted it to just be, like, let's film a video in one day, me and all my homies, we're all just gonna chill and just,
yeah,
like, go do the things we do in the summer, like, skateboard and whatnot, and have, a couple locations and just film the day and then make
okay
a video out of it, right?
Yeah.
It's, like, the sunflower spot, that was just totally random. We were on our way to the other location, which was Steep Rock, to film beach stuff. But then,
oh, yeah,
on the way there, because there's like, 3 cars worth of people, but I was driving Aiden and a couple other homies, and I saw the sunflowers, and I was like, we're gonna fucking stop there. And
yeah,
okay. So then, we pulled over next
okay
to there. The other guys were kind of pissed because we made them wait all the way at Steep Rock for a little longer than intended. But it ended up being worth it because, honestly, without those shots, probably wouldn't have had a good finished video because that was, like, a good portion of it. But, yeah, we pulled over and then just was like, let's just film in the fucking sunflower field. And
yeah. It was definitely a great, like, touch
yeah
to the video.
Yeah. So that was dope. And, yeah, that was just, like, a whole vibe. And it was, like, yeah, perfect. My favorite video, favorite, you know.
And then there's the other shots, too, of you performing, like, on the tent stage.
Oh, yeah. So I guess I'm kind of capping. So it wasn't all done in one day. That performance was done, like, maybe a couple, like, a week earlier.
Okay. And where was that? What was that?
So that was at a friend of mine. She was hosting a little event because, obviously, Folk Fest was canceled because of COVID. So she had her own Faux Fest. So it was, like, fake Folk Fest, right? And she lives in Headingley. So it's, like, she's got, like, a big backyard. She got together,
yeah,
like, she rented out, like, equipment, like, stage equipment, and was set up with, like, this other band performing, too, which are homies of mine. Shout out Love Letter Writers. Went to high school with them.
Okay.
Really dope guys. And they were like, you want to perform? You can perform too. So I was like, okay, bet. So I performed some stuff, and I performed Gemini there too, right? So I told Aiden, I was like, hey, like, I'm gonna be performing it if you want to, like, and he was like, if you want, I can come record your set, you know, whatever.
Yeah, wasn't get some shots, like.
Yeah, wasn't like I wasn't sure if it was gonna be in the music video per se. It was just like, hey, like, he wanted to come film, so he filmed it.
You just wanted content, like, from the concert.
Yeah, yeah, mm-hmm. Right? I was like, it'd be cool to do Gemini and perform it, right? And he had it recorded. So he did that, and then it ended up just being good for the video. Like, let's just put that in there, too, because it just ties everything in together.
Yeah, I really liked those shots. It looked, like, super fucking... I don't even know how to explain it. It looked really cool. Just having, like, the tent
stage in the background. It was a super, super vibey time. Super good
Mad Folk Fest mushroom vibes.
Oh, yeah. Everyone was on their little, like... fucking towel or blankets just sitting on the ground or like, you know what I mean? It was a good vibe. It was a good time, definitely.
But that's also, I need to know, that's like, that's what I like about your music. Like, you can slap it in the car or you can do a set at Folk Fest.
Weird.
Kind of thing. Like, like you can listen to it in so many different ways.
Yeah, no, like I appreciate
you,
that.
If you listen to it with subs, it'll slap.
It'll slap, yeah.
But, you know, homie can pull out a fucking mandolin and do a different rendition.
Yeah, no, 100%, 100%, yeah.
And then moving on to the most recent drop.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about it, man.
Yes, sir.
What goes up? This was a personal favorite track of mine that I've heard so far. And I will need to ask about the recording process of the song and then the video.
Okay.
So, first with the recording, what exactly is the song supposed to be about, and like, what's it supposed to display?
So the song idea for it, like most songs that I write, it's usually just starts off with a chorus idea. So I was at my homie Brian's studio in his basement, and we were and I was just recording, doing a session one day, just whatever, fucking around, and I ended up recording that hook, "What Goes Up Must Come." And I remember, like, getting him in there, and he was like, "Yo, that sounds so fire, like, what the fuck?" And I was like, yeah, this shit's hard. So I was like, this definitely has to be a song, like, I have to finish it. So I procrastinated, though, and it took me quite some time. I posted, like, right after the Gemini video, like, a little snippet, a little version.
Yeah, you guys in the studio, he had the guitar.
And at that point, the song was not done at all. Like, it was just that part, really. But I just wanted to put it out there just so people knew I was working on other stuff.
Okay.
And, so I ended up writing it, finishing it. I originally wanted to drop it for Valentine's Day, actually, because I thought that would be, like, a good, like, vibe, like, it matches right? But, again, I wasn't really done on the deadline I needed it to be done, so. But the idea for that song is basically just, like, it's just talking about, it's almost like a triumphant, like, anthem, like, in a sense of, like, relationships, like, whenever you first start a relationship, you have, like, those worries and whatnot. You're like, oh, like, is this really... You know, every relationship, I think, has, like, those very early stage, like, oh, is this really gonna work? Like, there's all these... There's things that happen, you know? It's, like, it's kind of like a turbulent little ride. And then eventually you get to a point, though, where it's just, like, kind of smooth sailing, right? And you're like, oh, like,
this is real. You guys kind of adjust real. And figure out, like...
Yeah, you know? So it's kind of like I was writing, like, what go... Like, people say, what, like... That's why I say, they say, what goes up must come down, because I'm saying, like, they're saying, you know, people always say, like, oh, you know, good things don't last. It's not gonna, you know.
Okay.
But it's basically, like, yeah, the song is supposed to be just, you know, me saying, hey, we made it. We're happy, you know, like.
This it worked
is,
out, kind
yeah,
of thing.
Yeah, exactly, you know, so.
Okay.
It's supposed to be like that, yeah.
And what was the, like, recording process like for it? Like, did you find that, like, the beat first and then you
so I found the beat just scrolling through random beats, you know, just looking, and I found that beat and I was like, it's like fire. And then that's when I found that melody and I came up with the hook, and then I was like, oh, this is fire. And then again, I didn't have a full song for it though, but I was like, I need to finish this, definitely. And then over time, I was just kind of like, nah, this is going to be the next job. This is definitely going to be the next release. And then it was kind of like I recorded it in spurs. So, like, some songs I can finish, like, in a couple days. Some songs in a couple weeks. This song took a couple months.
Okay. You really, like, took your time with it.
Yeah, like, I really wanted to make it so that it's just, like, I'm very, like, perfectionist in that sense.
That's good, though.
It's good, but it's also like it's bad because I feel like I overthink a lot of things when I'm writing. I'm like, oh, like this has to be perfect or this line has to be like this, right? But I kind of just let go of that at some point. And I was like, I'm just fuck it. I'm just gonna like have fun. Like this is how I make music. I can't just be thinking too much. So yeah. It came together, yeah, over time, and then I ended up having it done, and I was like, let's go. Like I couldn't have it up for Valentine's Day, so I was like, let's just post it. You know, in March, end of March. And
yeah, you decided to, like, take a little bit more time with it.
Yeah, and also, like, everything really took a lot of time with this. It wasn't even just the song. It was also getting the cover art. Because the cover art was, like, custom made.
Yeah.
I got it from a girl named Anna. So, shout out Anna. She's crazy. Very fire with the art. I was, like, I wanted to kind of resemble Gemini in the sense of, like, have, like, a theme. For most, like, I want to kind of have that theme going for a lot of my cover arts going forward, where it's like kind of like simplistic. There's like a backdrop color, you know, and there's like there's a meaning behind it. Like Gemini had a little meaning in it, and then this one, it's like the air balloon symbolizes, you know, it matches the
everything going up and then down.
Yeah, and she actually made like like that cover is a picture of she made like a whole. Clay sculpture of the air balloon.
Yeah, I remember seeing the picture.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
It was like
in pieces,
the making of.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. No,
so
it looked really cool.
So yeah, that took time, and then but it was it was kind of one of those things where I couldn't rush it. I just like I had to make sure everything was perfect, and then I was like, okay, we're good to go.
Yeah.
You know?
And rolling into the video, when did you decide like you wanted to do a video for that one? And you
know? Honestly, like, when I made it, I was like, this has to have a video with it.
Right away.
Yeah, instantly. I was like, no, this has to have a video.
And when you were, like, thinking about videographers right away.
Oh, 100%.
Aiden. You were.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's, like, my go-to. That's, like, my gun and turbo. Like,
yeah, okay.
That's, like, that, yeah.
And how'd you guys come up, like, with the whole green screen idea for that?
So, basically, the idea for the video at first was, I was like, I wanted to be like, because again, the idea was for Valentine's Day. So in my head, I was like, let's just make like a cute like little video, because the song is like kind of, you know, like not corny, but you know, there's like, it's supposed to be like over the top lovey. Like,
yeah.
So I was like, let's make a video where it's just me and a girl doing stuff, you know, going on dates. Yeah. But I was like, but that's, I think that's overplayed, you know? Like, I didn't want to just make some basic pop video. Oh, like, he's with a girl,
the typical,
and they're, oh,
like,
you know?
Cliche.
Yeah, so I was like, how can we do something different? And then I remember Aiden had mentioned to me a couple, like, way before. He was just like, oh, yeah, like, so I got a, he was just talking about how he got a green screen, but he hadn't used it yet at all for anything. He's never recorded. And he was like, yeah, I want to test it out sometime and do something with it. And then I just remembered that, and I was like, what's like, that would be, I was like, why don't we just film the whole thing on green screen and just see what the fuck happens? And I was like, and then we can just make it over the top ridiculous and make it fun. And then he was like totally on board. He's like, fuck it, yeah, let's just do it. And then we just went from there, basically.
Okay. And then like, how did you go about getting the model and then David, and like, how did they come into play?
So Betty, the girl that was in it, shout out Betty. I just hit her up on Instagram. I was just like, hey, we have some mutual friends, and they recommended that I should hit her up. I was like,
okay,
word, yeah. And then I just messaged her. She was totally down for it. She was like, yeah, like, I like your music, and I think it would be dope. Like, I told her the idea, and she was all down to do it. And then getting David was just, we were just like, hey, we need some pictures, you know? Dave is the guy, so we were like, fuck you, let's get him in. For him being in the video, though, that was just random. That was just like, we were filming, that whole shot was just, the idea was, oh, we're on a runway and I'm taking pictures of her, right? And then I was just like, halfway during shooting that portion, I was just like, yo, why don't we just get David to get in it and just take pictures
like
of us?
Paparazzi,
yeah, exactly.
Like, yeah.
I was like, that'd be funny. And he was just like, let's go. And I was like, yeah.
Okay.
And then it was just funny. And like, I was like, that's like the thing, that's what I love about like, that video in terms of like, and like the gem, it just ties with the Gemini video too. It's like, I really like authentic, just like fun moments. Like,
didn't take too much effort.
Like obviously we had to plan, like we planned all the scenes and the backgrounds and what, like what we were going to be doing, all the outfits and whatnot. But it's like the little things that made it on there that were just like the day of, or like, hey, why don't we just do this? Like, that'd be funny. Like, this will be funny too. Like,
in the spur of the moment, you think of like, yeah, add this.
I think it's the same thing with music. It's like, I think the best stuff I'll make is like randomly. I'll be sitting there and I'll be like, I think of a crazy line. I'm like, oh, let's go. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and you can just build so much just around that.
Yeah, exactly. So that's, yeah, that was basically how most of it came to be. I mean, obviously, yeah, heavily planned, but a lot of the funny moments were just like, hey, like, let's just throw this in right now over here.
Okay.
But yeah.
And then, yeah, talking more on, like, local artists and creators and stuff like that, how are you feeling with the whole, like, local scene and with everything going on in Winnipeg right now? What's your stance with everything?
I think that it's totally crazy right now. I think that it is the best it's ever been, and I'm, like, excited and I'm happy because it's, like, three years when I first started making music and whatnot, like, mm-hmm. I was in high school, it was like there was no one really making music in Winnipeg.
It was like pretty like a vast wasteline, yeah, for like a couple years.
The first artist I ever heard of was Miyazawa, and I thought that was dope. I was like, oh, that's okay. So cool that he's like doing his thing, right? I had respect. And I've had the fortunate chance of working with him too and whatnot. Like, it's been crazy. Like, a lot of things have just been accelerating in the past like 2 years. It was like I went from that to working with and connecting with like most of the artists that are now like
some of the biggest artists in the city.
Yeah, you know, like, yeah, it's crazy, and it's like a really, it's just really dope, and it's motivating too, because it's like, wow, like, you know, it almost in a sense pushes me to like go even harder too, you know. It's like, yeah, oh, I have competition,
people fuck
now
with me, like, yeah, they're putting out tracks, I gotta you putting out tracks too.
Exactly. Yeah, so I think it's crazy, it's great, you know. Yeah, it's dope.
Is there any like notable mentions of recent drops or artists you want to like pay homage
to? Well, obviously I gotta shout out LS, I gotta shout out Lost Souls, of course, Max of course. Wins, Fantastic Four, everyone in there, JTP, Dre, QQP, fucking C's, everybody, there's so many, but you know, that whole group, obviously, big shout outs to them, you know. I think that was also just another thing.
Man, Fantastic Four, the recent video.
Bro, that video is crazy. 40 Ooh. Diamonds, bro. Ooh. 40 Diamonds Killing is going it. Crazy right now.
Yes, sir.
So shout out 40. He's, he's doing a lot of stuff for the city too in terms of videos. That video is crazy. Miyazawa's been going crazy, yeah, dropping every week. Those videos are fire,
yeah,
too.
Every week, man.
Yeah, man, consistency's crazy. I want to get on that level one day.
Yeah,
I mean, obviously Fab, you know, like, definitely doing amazing things for the city, like craziness, you know. Other artists, I mean, obviously shout out Sean 2K, that's my brother.
Shout out
Sean 2K, shout out my homie AC Breeze too, he's doing his thing. You know, post-war, you know, there's a lot of artists, yeah, I can name right now, you know. I was listening to you know, Tight Beat by Ed Reilly. I was listening to that on the way here too. But yeah, like, there's a lot of artists, and it's cool because they all have their own like unique sound too. It's not just like, you know, it's dope. It's
there's a huge
dope
variety of like sub genre hip hop in Winnipeg.
Exactly, you know, like, everyone's doing their own thing, and it's just like, it's crazy to see. It's exciting for the city for sure.
Hell yeah. Are there any artists we can see you like working with in the future and stuff like that?
Right now, I don't have any features because I've just been like in my zone.
Okay.
Over the past like months, I've just been trying to work on my own like project and whatnot, and just like singles, and make like really, you know, develop, like, even though I feel like I've gotten kind of a sense of what my sound is, it's like I still every day I'm trying to, you know, push myself to make more better stuff and just get better and better. But there's definitely a lot of artists I want to work with, you know. I've worked with a lot of them, not necessarily all released tracks, but like, you know, I've worked with a lot of the big guys and whatnot. But like, there's a lot that I want to work with. I'm trying to think in my head right now. Fucking, I don't know. Honestly, I'm down to work with anybody. That's just the thing. So
it's just a matter of reaching out.
Me, when it comes to features, though, I'm very like, it's not that I'm picky, but it's more like, I feel like a lot of artists think of features as like a currency almost nowadays. It's like, It's like, hey, just hop on my song. Or like, hey, like, do you want to be on this song? But like, I will never ask an artist to be on my song unless I'm like, okay, like, I hear them on this song. Like, I want, like, their sound and my, like, we can, you know what I mean? Yeah,
right away you know, like, oh, I need a verse from this guy, like, yeah, to finish this section.
Like, it's always going to be art over everything else to me. It's like, at the end of the day, like, I'm making music that, like, I want to, it's like, from the creative standpoint, like, I need everything to be perfect and I need it to be, like, meticulously done and stuff like that. So,
okay. Has there been any, like, drama with anybody in the scene?
Drama?
That you've, like, noticed or, like, anything like that going on?
I mean, I'm not going to lie. Like, I feel like there was a lot, not as much these days. There's been a lot in the past, I feel like. I feel like there's a lot of, like, resentment towards certain artists. And yeah, there's been, like, a lot of, you know, like, just, like, behind the scenes, like, I don't like to entertain it personally, because I'm just, like, at the end of the day, like, we're all, like, we're almost, like, obviously we're all doing our own thing, and we're trying to, like, get, you know, to the next level, but if one of us wins, we all win. Like, if Miazway gets, like, blows up, then it's like we win. If Peso and Fantastic Four and all them, they blow up, we win. Max win. You know what I mean? It's like, I want to see everybody succeed, so I'm not like that. But like, there's definitely been some drama. I mean, I feel like you probably heard some too, right? Like, it's
dealing with all these rappers on the podcast, dude. Oh, I hear a lot of stories.
Yeah, I no doubt, you know. And like, I don't know. I mean, I heard like there was like that beef with, I don't know, you hear that diss track for Fab or something? Yeah, that was a big thing. I don't know. And it's almost like, I feel like we've come a long way. And again, like, we're all like a team. But there's still a little bit of that attitude where it's like, why is he doing better than me? Artists.
It's low-key, like, jealousy.
I don't get it personally. Because it's like, I've worked with Fab, right? But it was never like, oh my God, like I need to, you know, like, it just happened organically because it just happened. I don't know. But it's not like even now, like, I'm making my own type of music. I don't know how to explain it. Like, I don't think that, I think everyone is responsible for their own success. And I think that we should be supporting the people that put us on. I mean, the guy literally named his project Winnipeg's Anomaly.
Yeah.
Like, that's a pretty big deal, you know? So, don't know. I think that we should just be, like, and no hate to anybody, even the guy who made the song, you know? Like, it was, aside from, obviously, I don't agree with, like,
some of the things said.
Yeah, like, it was definitely still, like, a well-made track. Like, he's fire. I think that he has potential to make good music, too. But it's just, like, I think we need to eliminate that mentality. I feel like we really need to just, like, come together and support each other. Like, otherwise, we're not going to get anywhere. We'll see the
potential in each other and support it. And, like,
exactly. But it's, like, if one person... push
as much as you can.
Yeah, but as soon as someone starts doing a little bit better, we can't just be, like, why I should be that person. It's, like, no. Like, everyone has their own time and their own thing that they got to do. So, it's, like, you know.
Yeah, very true.
Yeah.
All right, Sam, man. So, you got to let the people know, what can we expect from you coming out in the future? Like, what's the future Sandman got for everyone, you know?
So, a couple more singles. A single probably dropping next month. I'm probably going to post a little thing and ask the people what they want. A couple, like,
this track or that?
Yeah, exactly. Then I have another track with a music video I want to drop a month after that. And then hopefully a project, my first EP coming out in the summer, June.
Okay.
Yeah.
And where can the people find you at that haven't heard you, or the people that, you know, just want to support your shit, anything like that?
Yeah, for sure. Well, you can find me on Instagram, SandmanXO, Twitter, same thing, SandmanXO. Spotify, just Sandman, Apple Music, I'm on all platforms, everything like that, yeah.
Yes, sir. And we're going in WPG Clark Podcast Freestyle with the one and only Sandman. Let's get it.
Jeez. Hey, yeah, hey, hey, yeah, hey, ooh, it's becoming heavy. Hey, yeah, hey, yeah, 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 hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah. I like my bitches in twos, I don't fuck with Geminis, I fuck with that girl,
but she is not no friend of mine. I got too many people trying to ask me for money these days, man. What the fuck did you expect? Man, I just want me a check. Give me some ice and just put on my neck. Froze it like I was a jeweler. Little bitch, come get it. Little bitch, come get your ooler. I gotta get your medulla. Wait. Yeah, I'm about to pop off. Yeah. Pop like it's sawed off. Shotgun is sawed off. Yeah, ayy. I'm from the city. I'm from the 204. The city that's cold. The city that don't show no love. Unless you got O's. Unless you got K's. I pull up a K and I shoot at your face. Shoot at your face. Pull up the case. We pull up with grief. Pull out the seats. Get the shit poppin', you know how it go. You know how it is, you know who's on float. Yeah, ayy, yeah. Young man, young San, 4 feet tall with a sort of slight tan. Started rapping in his fucking basement, yeah. Ayy, I was trapping out the spot, ayy. I was trying to get it out, fuck. Hey,
keep going, yeah. Keep going, let's get it.
Ayy, I feel just like a, yeah. Back on my shit like I'm Dennis, just like I'm Dennis the Menace, yeah. No, you cannot get no shit, you cannot get this, you rent this, you just, I keep that bitch out, she like a tenant, yeah. Bouncing back just like I'm tennis, yeah. Back on my shit like it's Tetris, puzzle pieces, yeah, it's Tetris, ayy. Back on my shit, back on these hoes, back on the flow. And you know how we get it poppin', you know how we get to droppin'. What goes up, what's gonna, what goes up must come down. Little bitch, come sit around my town. She don't wanna party with the kids, she just wanna party. She don't wanna get jit, okay, yeah. Ay, yeah. Ay, yeah. Ay, ay, yeah. Cartier frames, look at the frames. Look at the face, look at my chase. I drink the liquor, but don't give me chase. I do not chase, I just get O's, I just get hoes. I'm back on the chase. I'm back with my bros, we know how it goes. Straight from the snow, straight from the cold. That's the 204. Yeah, I don't know.
Yes, sir.
We got Sandman. Keep an eye out. More music coming. You haven't seen it. Go peep What Goes Up music video.
Must come down. Yes, sir.
Gemini, all that. All links that in description. Links you in already know. Like, comment, subscribe. It's your boy, WPG Clark. We out. Peace. Now you know.